Blackstone presents Our Flag Was Still There, the Star-Spangled Banner that survived the British and 200 years, and the Armistead family who saved it, by Tom McMillan. This book is read by Robert Fass. To Harry Armistead, George Armistead, and Christopher Hughes Morton, direct descendants of the hero of Fort McHenry, to Scott Sheeds, legendary historian and park ranger at Fort McHenry, and to Jennifer Jones, curator at the Smithsonian's National Museum of American History, for all that you do to keep the story of the Star-Spangled Banner alive. Chapter 1. An American Icon. This is the story behind the story of the most famous flag in U.S. history. It is on display today at the Smithsonian Institution, a tattered 200-year-old wisp of its former self, laid gently at a 10-degree angle in an environmentally controlled chamber with barely enough light to see the imperfections. Visitors peer through the glass in awestruck silence. Surprisingly massive at 30 by 34 feet, but still 8 feet shorter than its original width, perforated with holes and barely visible stitches from 2 centuries ago, breathtakingly thin, it is what remains of the iconic Star-Spangled Banner that flew over Fort McHenry in Baltimore on September 14, 1814, after Major George Armistead and his exhausted, rain-soaked troops withstood a 25-hour bombardment by the British Navy. Watching closely that morning was a 35-year-old lawyer and amateur songwriter named Francis Scott Key, whose presence on the deck of a nearby ship was a quirk of fate. Detained by the British during the battle, waiting anxiously for dawn to break as gunfire petered out, Key scribbled frenetic notes, wondering if a U.S. flag still flew over the fort. The end of his song's first verse, completed 2 days later, was even punctuated with a question mark. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave? By the time he got around to his notes for a second verse, Key had his answer. Straining through his spyglass from several miles away, he could make out the stars and stripes of the United States hanging defiantly from the flagpole. The fort and the city had been saved, and perhaps the young country with them. His heart filled with patriotic joy as he applied an exclamation point. "'Tis the star-spangled banner, O long may it wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave." Key's lyrics, written to the music of To Anacreon in Heaven, a tune he knew well, would not become the official national anthem until 1931. But they did more than just give the big flag its nickname. They captured the essence of a defining moment in the country's history. It is easy to forget that the Battle of Baltimore took place only 38 years after the Declaration of Independence. A defeat by the British at Fort McHenry in September 1814 could have altered the course of human events in ways we can't imagine. Moreover, although the American flag had been displayed with pride since its creation in 1777, it was still not viewed as a symbol that tied the former colonies together. Key's song, written with the rare perspective of an eyewitness to the battle, gave it that special stature. What Key really started, said the Smithsonian's Jeffrey Brody, was the transformation of the flag from a military utilitarian symbol to something that embodied new definitions of American identities and ideals. The idea for such a massive version of the flag had come 1 year earlier from Major Armistead himself. He wanted a banner at Fort McHenry so large that the British would have no trouble seeing it from a distance, but he had no idea he was setting in motion a series of events that would lead to the national anthem, the national motto, In God We Trust, which is lifted from Key's fourth verse, and 2 centuries' worth of celebration and controversy. The momentous task of making the flag went to a Baltimore seamstress named Mary Young Pickersgill, whose mother had sewn banners for George Washington and the Continental Army during the Revolutionary War. Mary's gigantic masterpiece of 15 white stars on a blue background and 15 red and white stripes, the official design of the time, was completed in August 1813 and flew over the fort for a full year before the famous British attack. And yet, it is only because of the diligence of the Armistead family that the old flag exists today. Early details of the chain of custody are murky, but the most likely scenario is that George Armistead took it home as a souvenir sometime after the battle, in a clear violation of U.S. Army regulations. Over the next 90 years, it remained in the private possession of the Armistead family in Baltimore and New York City.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.